Oh, it is you, ma'am. I couldn't tell.
The butler said you would be here.
I come here for the rooks. They're sociable animals. A gathering like this is called a parliament. Altogether more civilized than their human equivalent.
I'm sorry to disturb you, Lord M. But I had to talk to you.
Rocket Hall is honored, ma'am.
I've come here incognito, of course.
Of course. Your presence cannot be entirely disguised.
Yesterday, I realized something.
Yes, ma'am?
I think perhaps now I'm speaking as a woman and not as a queen. At the beginning, I thought that you were the father I never had. But now I feel, I know, that you are the only companion I could ever desire.
Did you know that rooks mate for life? Every year they build their nests together. You renew all those little civilities that make a marriage sparkle. I think we could learn much from them. If I had to spend more time watching the rooks, my wife would have felt more attended to.
She should never have left you. I would never do such a thing.
No. I believe when you give your heart, it will be without hesitation. But you cannot give it to me.
I think you have it already.
No, you must keep it intact for someone else. I have no use for it, you see. Like a rook, I'm mate for life.
I see. Then I'm sorry to have disturbed you, Lord Melbourne.